What sort of Italian wine should you serve with Italian food? Well, I'm here at Chicago's Osteria Viestato with my friend Adam Seeger to find out. And as you can see, he's decanting a bottle of Barolo. Now, Adam, what is the first thing people should really think about in terms of pairing Italian wine with Italian foods?
Well, the most important is to remember the old adage of what grows together goes together. And that's especially important in Italy, where there are over 20 regions, 2,000 varietals of grapes, many of which we haven't even heard of or can even pronounce very well. So if we go back to just what wines are from the regions, from the food that is being inspired, you're going to have some really wonderful pairings, and you're going to have a chance to try some wines that you may not have been comfortable trying otherwise.
And here comes Chef David DiGregorio with the first course. Adam, what is this?
This is Parmesan crusted fennel, and fennel grows wild all over Tuscany. So we wanted to do a very typical blend of grapes from the region, one of the venerable families that's been in Tuscany for centuries. And this is a blend of Trebbiano and Malvasia. I really love, especially with the Parmesan, you've got some richness there, and certainly with the cheese. I think the Malvasia, you want something with a little bit more oomph and personality.
Now, Adam, what dish is this?
This is a pescatore, which is a fish stew from Liguria. And Chef David is going to finish it with some Ligurian extra virgin olive oil. We're pairing this with Bisson Cinque Terre. It's a white wine from Liguria, from the region where the fish stew comes from. 2005, really great, beautiful vintage in Italy.
How does the flavor of the wine work with the olive oil?
Well, the Vermentino is going to give it a little bit of depth and richness, which is certainly what the olive oil, and then the local varieties, I think, with the fish fresh from the Mediterranean, pairs really perfectly.
Now, what is this dish?
This is homemade pappardelle with Osteria's famous meat ragu. And we're going to serve this with a Nicodemi Montepulciano d'Abruzzo. Really, really fun pairing. Montepulciano traditionally can be as simple as a pizza wine, but it's one that I think can really hold up to a very rich, flavorful meat dish.
Oh, great, it's pizza.
Well, this is one of our signatures from Pizzeria Viestato. We've got some homemade sausage, caramelized onions, a Fontina d'Aosta, which is just at the base of the Alps near Piemonte, where Barolo comes from, and a little bit of mushrooms as well, which is very typical of the area. And we're serving this with a Pio Cesare Barolo 2003. We kind of tried to put the wine list together as a way that someone could look at what they're going to be ordering and then very easily find a wine that they may not have even heard of the region or the grape, but because it came from the region they came from, they're going to have something that's going to taste really delicious and complement each other.
Well, this has been a really great lesson in food and wine pairings. Thank you. Look for me in the Good Eating section of Wednesday Chicago Tribune and Sunday's Q section. I'm Bill Daley for the Chicago Tribune.
Cheers.
Cheers.